All right, now we're gonna do a cam bearing install. Okay, new cam bearing. Always check the bore. The bore is perfect. This is a brand new bearing. Now it's wise to use the actual install tool. Which I have here. Okay. So here's the install tool. It slips on the end there. Put the bearing there. Now, you see the lettering? On one side, kind of rounded on the other. Take the lettering, put that so it's facing out. Put a wee bit assembly lube. Should use a bearing installer because this gets kind of plate gets mounted. On the front of the case, and it's pretty much lined up. To line up with the bore. So you don't have to mess with it. Just gotta snug it. You don't need to tighten it. Screw it on in, so at least it gets up to the bore, so it lines up. And like I said, the reason why you want the tool is because once it screws it in all the way, it's got a shoulder, so it puts it at the perfect depth just below the shoulder. So just go ahead and push it in. Keep an eye on it. And then once the tool bottoms out, that's it. It's all the way in, and it's also in at the correct go. Take your plate screws off. Pull this out. in there. It now sits just below, maybe a 32nd of an inch. It needs to be. So that's the correct way. That's how, when it comes time to put your cam in, there's your tab thrust washer, and then of course your thrust washer. Of course, this is the old one, so I don't know if I'm going to be using this one because I still got to do end play, but this is just for reference. And there you go. So that would be how it goes. Now the cam I'm using is an Andrew 48. Good cam. So here you go. That's what it looks like. There you go. Next time, I'll be putting the oil pump shaft with the gear. I'm going to show you how that's done. Kind of easy to do, actually. You have the right angle snap ring pliers, makes it easy. But that's it so far on that. So for now, I'll leave it. Talk later.